Come to next question. A solid cylinder has total surface area 231, core surface area is 2/3 of total surface area. Find the volume of the cylinder. So, total surface area is 231, core surface area is 2/3 of the total surface area. Find the volume. So, first, what is total surface area? 2 pi r into h plus r is equal to 231. It's okay? And core surface area is 2 pi r h is equal to 2 by 3 of total surface area. Means total surface area is 231. 2 into 77 is equal to 154. So 2 pi r h is 154. From here, multiply this 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square is equal to 231. What is your 2 pi r h value? It is 154. So substitute here 154 plus 2 pi r square is equal to 231, or 2 pi r square is equal to 231 minus 154. So 2 pi r square is equal to 77. So what is your r square? R square is equal to 77 into 7 by 44. So 11 cot it 7, 4 is equal to 49 by 4, or r is equal to square root of 49 by 4, it is 7 by 2. So you got the value of r. Now substitute here 2 pi r h is equal to 154, 2 into pi 44 by 7 into r is 7 by 2 into h is equal to 154. So h is equal to 154 by 22, it is 7. So h is equal to 7, r is equal to 7 by 2. Now you can easily find the volume, that is pi r square. It's okay. Come to next important question. The radius of two cylinders are in the ratio 2:3 and their height are in the ratio 5:3. Calculate the ratio of their volume and the ratio of their core surface area. Let's say radius is r1, radius is r2, height is h1, height is h2. So here it is given that radius of two cylinders are in the ratio 2:3. That means R1 by R2 is equal to 2 by 3, and height are in the ratio, that means H1 by H2 is equal to 5 by 3. Then calculate the ratio of their volume and ratio of their core surface area. So ratio of their volume and ratio of their core surface area. So ratio of their volume, R1 by R2 is 2 by 3, means 2x, this is 3x. R1 is 2x left, R2 is left 3x. Similarly, H1 is 5y and H2 is 3y. Now it is easy to find out. So volume 1 by volume 2 is equal to pi R1 square H1 by pi R2 square H2 is equal to R1 by R2 square is how much? R1 by R2 is 2 by 3. So R1 by R2 square is 4 by 9 into H1 by H2 means 5 by 3 is equal to 20 by 27. Similarly, core surface area two pi RH means R1 into H1 by 2 pi R2 into H2 is equal to R1 by R2 is how much? 2 by 3 into H1 by H2, how much? 5 by 3. So is equal to 10 by 9. Come to next important question. Already this type of question we are discussed. Just see, a rectangular sheet of paper 44 cross 22 is rolled along the length to form a cylinder. Find the volume of the cylinder. So a rectangular paper 44 cross 20 centimeter is rolled along its length. Find the volume of the cylinder so generated. So in the example section we are already discussed. A piece of paper 44 cross 20 is rolled along its length. So this is the paper. If this paper is rolled along the length, this is the length part. So rolled along the length means like this, it is rolled to make a cylinder. That means here we make the cylinder like this. So this is your height. This is 20 and length is 44. So length 44 means like this you rolled means, and breadth is 20 means the height of the cylinder formed is 20. And 44 is your circumference of the cylinder. It's okay? So now rolled along the length means 2 pi r is equal to 44 and height is equal to 20. It's okay? This is the cylinder formed. So first find the r. This is 44 by 7 r. So r is equal to 44 into, this is 44 by 7. If you bring this side, it is 7 by 44 means r is equal to 7. And h is 20. So simply find pi r square h to find the volume. It's okay. Come to next important question. This is a very, very important and previous year question. Just carefully observe this. The core surface area of a cylindrical pillar is 264 meter square and its volume is 924 meter cube. Find the diameter and height of the pillar. Find the diameter and height of the pillar. It's okay. So core surface area is 264 means 2 pi r h is equal to 264 and volume means pi r square h is equal to 924 meter cube. Just divide these two. So here to pi r h will cancel. It will be 2 by r. Just see, pi pi cancel, r square cancel, r will remain, h h will cancel. Is equal to 264 by 924, you cut it by 4. So 2 by r is equal to 2 by 7. So 2 will cancel. So r is equal to 7. So diameter is equal to 14. It's okay. Now to find h, simply put here 2 pi r h, 2 into pi is 22 by 7 into r is 7 into h is equal to 264. It's okay. So h is equal to 264 by 44 is equal to, cut it directly, it will be 6. So 6, 14 meter and height is 6 meter. It's okay. Next question. The well of diameter 14 meter is dug 8 meter deep. The earth taken out of it has been evenly spread all around it to a width of 21 meter to form an embankment. Find the height of the embankment. This question already I have discussed in example part. So just carefully observe whose diameter is 14 and height is 8 meter. The earth dug out form an embankment all around it. So this is your embankment. This part is your embankment. The well of diameter 14 meter means r is equal to 7 meter. This is your r. Okay? The earth dug out form an embankment all around the well. It means this is your well part. All around it, this is an embankment. It is formed. Embankment is in the form of a hollow cylinder. It's okay? The embankment is in the form of a hollow cylinder. The earth dug out form an embankment means the volume of the embankment is equal to volume of the well. Embankment is in the form of a hollow cylinder. That means here the width is given to you 21 meter. So r is equal to 7 meter. Width is 21 means r minus r is equal to 21 meter. Means big R is equal to, this is 7, so 21, bring this side plus 7 is equal to 28 meter. As volume of the embankment is in the form of a hollow cylinder, the volume is pi big R square minus small r square into h is equal to volume of the well means pi r square h. It's okay. Now this is r plus r into r minus r into h. H means you have to find it out. H is equal to r square h. R is your how much? 7 square into h. H is height of the well, means it is 8 meter. It's okay. So this is your 28 and this is your 7. So 35 into r minus r means width. Width means 21 into h is equal to 49 into 8. So h is equal to 49 into 8 by 35 into 21. So 7 3 ja, 7 5 ja, so is equal to 8 by 15 meter, or is equal to 8 by 15 into 100 centimeter. So is equal to 160 by 3 centimeter. Come to next question. This question already I have discussed in the example part, so carefully observe. This is a very, very important question. The difference between inside and outside surface area of a cylindrical tube of 14 cm long is 88 square centimeter. If the volume of the tube is 176 cubic centimeter, find the inner and outer radii of the tube. So length is 14 cm means height is 14 cm. And difference between inner and outer, that means outer minus inner, is 88 centimeter square and volume is 176 centimeter cube. It's okay. Find the inner and outer radii of the tube. That means find R and R. So here, if you take 2 pi h as common, it will be R minus R is equal to 88, or this is 44 by 7, 2 into pi 44 by 7, 2 into 22 by 7, into h is 14, into r minus r is equal to 88. So r minus r is equal to, this is 44 into 2, 88, divide this. So r minus r is equal to 1. Next step, volume is 176 cm cube. Volume means pi big r square minus small r square into h is equal to 176. So 22 by 7 into r square minus r square means r plus r into r minus r into h is 14 is equal to 176. So this is 1. So r plus r is equal to 22 into 2, 44. So 176 by 44 is equal to 4 cm. So r plus r is equal to 4, r minus r is equal to 1. Simply add them. 2r is equal to 5, or r is equal to 5 by 2. Now substitute here. 5 by 2 plus small r is equal to 4, or r is equal to 4 minus 5 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2. This is 2.5, this is 1.5 centimeter. It's okay.